to the artists who influenced their career.
The first one we did was in 83, I think, you know, which was 3 years after we first recorded. And it was just to show everybody where we were coming from, you know, and why we were into reggae and how we'd got into reggae, you know. And, you know, we've got a list of maybe 200 songs that we could do, you know, all from that era, sort of 67 to 71, which is the birth of reggae. Every single one of the Labour of Love tracks on all three volumes was all number one in the reggae charts. Mm-hmm. Every single track. And all we're doing is a tribute to those records, mm-hmm. you know. That's all we've ever wanted to be, is ambassadors for reggae, you know, successful ones. That's all we ever wanted to be.
And we haven't made those records to inspire any kind of nostalgic feeling in people, you know. We haven't done it to sort of make us look back to the greater days. We've tried to introduce these tracks now because they've not been heard by a lot of people. And we think that they're great songs, you know, and they should get a wider exposure.
We actually recorded, I think,
26
tunes anyway, and then carried on working on 15. We ended up with a final list of 15, but there's 10 other tunes that we're equally as happy with, really,
yeah,
you know,
yeah.
Which means we've started Labour of Love 4, doesn't
that
it?
Exactly, yeah.
But until then, Volume 3 offers a selection of cover versions of classic reggae tunes, like Peter Tosh's Legalise It, A Petition to Legalise Cannabis, a subject which is close to the band's heart.
It just seemed, it seemed a very fitting one to put on the album. Is there any really sort of half-serious lyric
yeah,
on the album?
Really. It's only lyric that's got, like, a message.
Yeah, the rest are sort of love songs and that, you know. It's a sentiment we all thoroughly support, you know, and have publicly done so for many years.
I think people should stand up and say, you know, I mean, I think there's an awful lot of people who in privately think it should be legalised and then in publicly that won't admit it, you know, and I think it's about time people just said what they thought.
And being honest, boys, UB40 confess that they're prepared to continue as ambassadors of reggae music for as long as possible.
When we started, I didn't imagine we'd last longer than 2 or 3 years.
Exactly,
I really
yeah.
didn't, you know, and now here we are. 18 years, you know, recording, and it doesn't seem,
it seems like
just yesterday.
So, yeah, I guess we will carry on as long as people want us to, you know. As long as people want to buy records and come and see us live, we'll carry on doing it.
Very often giggle, you know, thinking, well, you know, we're so lucky because you can't predict that kind of success, you know. You have to be very, very, very lucky and then work to capitalise on that luck, you know, but you can never predict it, you know, but it's incredible, really. We sometimes laugh, you know, at each other thinking, wow, we've been lucky.
I walk around my house and think, God, how did I ever end up in a house like this? Mm. And I know it's because I'm in UB40.